Hello, this is the Red Stranger.
This is Nagol the Impaler.
And we are playing Project Zomboid. Project Zomboid is done by the Indie Stone, and essentially they just started out with The Sims 3, and they ended up saying, we want to do something beyond mods. We're going to do our own game. And they came up with an idea. What would you do in the zombie apocalypse? It's a question you ask in the pub all the time, or you're here in America land, the bar, because these guys are British.
Hi, Brits.
Essentially, what the game is about is you survive as long as you can in the zombie apocalypse.
Good luck.
Yes, and essentially, this is how you died. Okay, what should we name our character?
Greg.
Greg.
Oops.
You're not good with the capitals. Caps lock.
Mick Whitepants.
Mick McTyrone Goldstien.
That was my second choice.
Greg McTyrone Goldstien, multi-ethnic man.
Okay, his job is construction worker.
Yes.
He's thick-skinned. That means the zombies can't bite through his skin because his skin's thick. Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's handy.
Makes sense.
He likes to use his hand. You hear that, ladies? Available traits. I think we should do a completely negative man one.
Yes.
Yeah, it's we should do a challenge. Yes, a super challenge. We're gonna use every negative one. He's a light drinker. He gets easily sloshed. He's short-sighted, a hypochondriac, hard of hearing, claustrophobic, weak, cowardly, clumsy, prone to illness, brooding, overweight, agoraphobic, which means he's afraid of both inside and outside places.
Nice.
He has a hearty appetite, which means he has to eat more. Short-tempered. So, Mr. Greg Tyrone Goldstien, construction worker, is a light drinker, short-sighted, hypochondriac, hard of hearing, claustrophobic, weak, cowardly, clumsy, prone to illness, brooding, overweight, agoraphobic, has a hearty appetite, and is short-tempered.
He's me!
And we're off. I'm playing it first. Usually you can get spawned in places that completely screw you over.
That's just fine.
Yeah, you know how you randomly spawn in places that screw you over. You know, if you spawn in Saudi Arabia, your life sucks.
You're gonna offend them.
No one has YouTubes in Saudi Arabia.
That's racist.
And I started out without my shirt. And my character's absolutely frightened in being in a little room.
I think he has some other things to be worried about.
I found my first weapon, a frying pan.
Yes.
Ooh, chocolate. Found some canned soup.
Everyone needs Campbell's.
I'm gonna eat pie. I have an empty water bottle. I'm gonna fill this full of water. Boop. I can also move furniture with my half-naked body.
He is a...
I have mind
sexy,
powers.
Sexy construction.
You gotta be careful, because some rooms are infested. You have to check them. This is like your perception meter, right?
Right.
And you can see through this. You can't see through anything else. I can't see through these rooms. I have to be in it. And it takes a while for me to see. Okay, my character is absolutely frightened.
I think he's dying of a heart attack.
You can hear his heart going boom, 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 boom. Started in the- Oh, gosh!
He's a hummingbird.
I saw people through that windows.
Ah, people.
I can't let them see me through
going to be eaten by zombie peoples.
Hello?
Uh-oh.
I heard noises. I heard noises, too.
I think they hear your heartbeat.
Yeah, they probably hear my heartbeat.
And you are going to die.
There's someone half across the state that can hear my heartbeat. Do you hear something?
I do. It sounds ugly enough like a heartbeat.
You know, I found a bowl. I'll fill it full. Oh, that's a zombie.
Oh, boy.
Did you see the zombie?
It's
wandering around.
Zombie.
It's been a zombie. Who puts their bed like that? Where am I putting all this stuff?
You're shirtless.
Yes.
Your pants must have lots of pockets.
I can only carry 50 pounds of stuff.
Wow.
And like the normal thing, you can carry a buttload. It's ridiculous.
A buttload, he said.
A buttload. Oh, yeah, I just got it. Look what I did there. I'm floating. I can gobble up this whole watermelon.
Do it.
But it would be wasteful. You have to cut up the watermelon into little pieces. It's the only way.
I'll bash it with this way.
Oh, I can't bash it with the frying pan. Maybe I can use
this
a butter knife.
This gaming realistic.
This game is super realistic. It has zombies. That's so realistic. See? And you can't use the knife. Yeah, on the forums, no one wants it. I don't want it because it'd be really tedious.
How would one empty one's bowel? Once you eat watermelon, you have to poop. It's just, it's nature.
It's the way of life.
It's nature.
Just like the zombies. It's absolutely realistic. Bananas.
I want. Plus, in Project Zomboid, you're stuck in a room having to fend for yourself and eat whatever you can. One of the most entertaining things to do is to be seeing what comes out of you.
Speaking of what comes out of you, where are these peas?
Are those frozen peas and you just shove them in your pants?
Yes. Can't you hear them jingle?
You'd think your heart rate would lower.
Did my heartbeat suddenly just skip? Did you hear that?
I did.
Oh, I know what I can do.
Carrot watermelon sandwich.
Yes. Why can't I make that game? There's a crafting station in this, but they won't let me do. Ooh, my guy is about to die. How did he make it this far?
I don't know.
I'm scared to open doors because if I have to fight something, this guy's screwed.
He's gonna have a heart attack.
Yeah, he'll have a heart attack. He'll heart attack to death. Did you just hear that? His heart went.
A hummingbird.
He says, it says, strong panic, accuracy severely reduced, and I have very heavy load. I don't think my guy's going to survive very long.
You would have that very heavy load if you could use the bathroom.
It's 2 o'clock in the morning, so my guy can't sleep right either. His sleeper ticker thing's broken.
How did he survive through the zombie apocalypse?
Yeah, it's supposed to be, you know, it starts 2 weeks into it, and if you go out there during night, you're a dead man.
Yes.
Perfect timing. Woo! There's a grocery store down there. You want to use the apartments? They're safe but dangerous because it takes them a long time for them to evade the area.
That's true.
But
he's kind of freaking out though.
Yeah, he's kind of freaking out. But he'll freak out outside too.
No matter what, he's always gonna just freak out.
I think he's just permanently broken like that.
Yeah, traumatic experience as a kid.
With a zombie. Oh no, Uncle Rob. I'm gonna cook. Okay, I gotta time it perfectly.
Ramen noodles.
Cook bowl.
Woo!
That was super entertaining.
College all over again.
Yes. Here's a pro tip. Cook all your food as soon as you can and bring up your cooking skill at least one. And that improves your how well your food is and how you ration it. And then put it in a fridge so when the power goes out around a week later, you'll have all that cooked food. And you won't be like stuck with raw meat. Oh, and if you get bit in this game, you're dead. There's a little small chance for a dry bite, kind of like a snake, but it's really rare. It's like a 2% chance.
Yeah.
Water goes out too.
Your heart's no longer beating very fast.
Oh, look!
Ramen noodles was the cure all along.
Ramen noodles is the cure,
you know,
for post-traumatic stress.
All that sodium would help you.
That's delicious for your heart.
Mm-hmm. Doctors are dead.
I hear people walking. This guy is supposed to be overweight. To be overweight, he sure does look buff. I don't think they got the sprites down right. Watch, they put buff and the guy's 5,000 pounds. He looks like Jabba the Hutt.
Brr. Oh yeah, that's my kind of
look at this piece of beefy man cake.
I'm going in the middle of the dark up these steps. That's just
now you're panicking again.
I died on the steps once in this game.
Congratulations.
I only got 7 hours in, and it was a glitch, and I died a horrible, horrible chicken. My life has meaning now. Make a boop. Ba-doop. There we go. Ba-doop.
How about you leave that on there and burn down the whole part?
I can't do it with this model yet. I can't burn buildings down. Saintly saints of Hyrule, I have made a cream cheese sandwich.
Gods be praised. Whiskey bottle.
I found some whiskey. Let's get cracked. Whiskey and a lollipop. So there's some weirdo that's in here.
Put some whiskey.
Is that a dirty magazine? And some lollipops. This guy's into weird stuff, man. This is a guy you don't meet at church.
This is a realistic game.
Yeah, this is a realistic game. It gives a great outlook on humanity. This is pouring some whiskey and lollipops.
Yay.
Woo. My heart stopped. So we haven't even encountered our first zombie yet. We've been this guy's too scared to get out of here. I'm just preparing my forts right now.
It gets funner.
Yeah, it gets funner. And because with the superpower of editing, you'll probably be instantly immersed into zombies like this. He has a light drinker, so look. How's it doing? Hey, how's it going?
Guy getting ripped apart. Hey, keep her down there.
Hey, Chuck.
It's all as good as me.
Now he wishes he could use that bathroom.
Don't ask him, the bell tolls for. The bell tolls for Argon.
It's coming yourself. burnt dead chicken.
The smell of burnt dead avian flesh soothes my soul.
I like how this guy's reasoning. He's just thinking about, that would make me another sandwich. Put it in the fridge. I can't. Look, who puts good popcorn in the fridge?
I would. Because you know, that's not everything. Oh no, my grandma has been eating. I'm trying
to look
Yeah, I knew you'd laugh.
That's why I said it. What I have? I have a whole thing of Folgers in my butt. I'm going to pull that out.
First part of waking up, Folgers in your butt.
I'm pressing the straight button. I'm not making him do that. He's just being-
Oh, I failed!
Oh my gosh, I broke myself. I fell and hurt myself.
Fell and broke your leg. He was totally prepared for the zombie.
I'm gonna go outside anyway. Yeah, I'm starting to get in this, man. I'm starting to feel the power.
So I have to make a pee-pee.
Because
in real life, you actually have to pee.
I'm going to be back.
I'm fired.
Good luck.
Wow. You get me killed. My friend just left.
Look at this piece of perfume, man.